I have returned. And I've returned with Resident Evil Afterlife. Been throwing up a number of videos today. This may be the only one that shows up. I don't know what's going to happen. So, you may just see this one. If you see the others, cool. Hacksaw Ridge, Lone Survivor. We'll see what happens. But this film... I'm a Resident Evil fan. Well, sort of. I like the first one and I like this one. I think some of the other ones were pretty weak. Especially the last two. But this one, I liked. This 4K version is from a 2K digital intermediate. It has a 7.1 audio track and also supports Dolby Atmos. The Blu-ray of this movie already looked good. This is just an upgrade to that. If you're a Resident Evil fan, if you own it already, I don't necessarily know that, you know, it makes sense to go and purchase it again. Unless you do have a 4K set or a larger screen, like 65 larger projector, and you want a cleaner image, I would definitely recommend picking this up. If you're a hardcore Resident Evil fan, I would recommend picking it up for your 4K setup, but I certainly wouldn't go out and buy a 4K television and Blu-ray player for this movie. Picture quality wise, it's not at the top, but it's not at the bottom. It's sort of in between the top and the middle. It looks good. There are moments where there is grain in certain dark scenes, but that's the same with the Blu-ray, and it was probably just hard to either cut that out or it was the way the film was shot. But when you get past those moments, it looks spectacular. So I'm going to show you like one of the opening scenes because I think it's a good representation of the different sort of shadow detail, color range, a lot of different things that make this movie look really good in 4K. Now again, I shoot in 4K, so if it doesn't show up that way right away, just wait a while, come back, and then change the settings in your YouTube to take advantage of that if you have a 4K monitor. Something else I was going to say now, and I don't even remember what it is. But anyway, we're going to take a quick look at the Blu-ray first, as usual. So, let's go here. So the Blu-ray, as you can see, looks very nice. The film itself, to me, this is a 5, is a 3.5, 3.5. I mean, for this sort of film, it is what it is. You turn your brain off, put your feet up, and just enjoy it. You know, don't expect this isn't going to be Ben-Hur or Citizen Kane. It's a decent kind of gore film. And the Blu-ray looks great. The difference between the two is almost slight, because as I have it now, as I'm showing you, I've got the upscaler off. The backlight on the TV is off in this mode, in this input. It won't be for 4K. 4K will be all the bells and whistles. But I'm trying to approximate for you what it'd be like watching the same movie on a 65-inch television that was, just a 65-inch 1080p television. And then I'll jump over to the 4K version, as I'm going to do now, and give you an idea of what that looks like. Now, of course, keep in mind, as I've said many times before, what you're going to see is really based on what I'm capable of capturing with my camera. My camera is 4K. My camera will also capture, you know, you'll be able to see the difference in the luminance and things like that to what we're watching, but you're not going to notice any of the variance in colors. You may be able to notice some of the shadow details, sure, but, you know, there are things you're not going to be able to pick up just watching this at home on a non-4K set, and even on a 4K set, or a 4K set with HDR, so keep that in mind. A lot of this is just me showing you what I can and giving you my opinion based on that. So here we go with the 4K version. Now, immediately what I notice is the difference in the luminance and like the buildings when you look at the lights, and also in the shadow detail in the city on the ground. I can see more in like the alleyways on the tops of the buildings, and they're easier for me to pick out because of how the HDR handles the difference in the gradations of black. Also, in these colors, they're more vibrant, and I can see a difference in some of the shades of like the red or the yellow in the umbrellas and in people's raincoats and stuff like that. But it's not a night and day difference in the Blu-ray. It's just slightly upgraded. In the Blu-ray, her shoes actually have a little bit more of a... Everything's kind of a sharp red, but it's all the same red. Whereas looking at it here, her shoes are a slightly different shade of red than they were in the Blu-ray version. But the stockings, I can see more detail and sort of more gradation and color in the stockings and the black to the gray. Both great transfers. But I just wanted you to get a chance to take a look at this. I mean, it's a budget release. It's $22.99 here versus the $35 of most of the new releases. So I would definitely recommend this film. I don't know if I mentioned again, it's a 2K digital intermediate upscaled to 4K. It's got a 7.1 audio soundtrack and also supports Dolby Atmos. So if you're running, like I run a 7.1 setup, if you're running Atmos on top of that, or just Atmos, whatever your configuration, you'll probably really enjoy this film. I mean, Atmos, that kind of stuff is really key to these action films. We have so much going on, and Resident Evil is a very busy film. So, hope this helps you make a decision on some of your purchases. And if you want to comment, of course, thank you for the likes. Thank you for those of you that have subscribed. It's appreciated. And I will keep doing what I'm doing, and hopefully some of this stuff will get up. If not, I'll just have to do some of these videos without the visual. Have a great day. Much love. Peace.